Halloween, everybody. Hey. If you're wondering what I am, am I lit up?
Yeah, you are.
If you're wondering what I am, I'm spicy ketchup. Oh. And don't fork with me. Anyway, today we're going to teach you a few things about some components that have to do with fire, and we're going to make some indoor s'mores. So let me teach you first about something that you might need if you entertain at your house. This, my friends, is a fire in a can, or we call it canned heat. Some brand names is Sterno. I just always call it Sterno. But this is called Heat It. It comes in different sizes, 2 hour, 4 hour, 6 hour, 8 hours. They're larger. So there's flammable liquid inside of it. And then you just light it. So besides using it for indoor s'mores, the real purpose, I'll show you what the real purpose is. It's to use it for shaping dishes. What is a shaping dish? Well, there's all these components of a shaping dish. We do caterings, or maybe some of you might have shaping dishes at your house. Anybody? Different sizes, they come in round. That's the best way to entertain, and especially if you're serving hot food. Because if you're serving hot food, you probably make the hot food, or people bring hot food over, and then suddenly you just put it out on a buffet table, on a table, and it sits there, it gets cold, plus it gets in that temperature when all the bacteria is breathing away, and that's how people leave your party, and 4 hours later they are puking their brains out and diarrhea because you didn't have a dang shaping dish. Okay, so they can get these, you can buy these at Costco, and I'm going to teach you how to put out this fire, of course. Smother it. You can buy them at Costco. So here is a shaping dish stand. This is the shaping dish water pan. It's a water pan. It's not a hotel pan. This is not the pan you put the food in. You put a little bit of water in there. We have like half inch of water in there. Then you would put, watch out because these can be really hot. You would put the Sterno in there, and then of course you would light it. You would light it about, You would light it about 45 minutes, an hour before you need to put the hot food in. This will be steaming, okay? And it's ready for the hot food. Say I have mac and cheese and mashed potatoes, straight hot out of the oven or stove, and I put it in here. This would be steaming again. And then, of course, I would put the lid on top. And suddenly, ding dong, all your guests come, and that's when you're like, oh, I'm ready for you. Voila. And then always you remember long-handled cooking utensils. Why? Because if you have a short-handled one, and you'll remember this every time you go to buffet, next time you go to Vegas, Reno, whatever, and buffet, oh, salad bar, and you have someone using the tongs, and you see these people all in line before you. You don't know if they picked their nose, picked their butt, what? They did, right? They're touching, everyone's touching the tongs or whatever, and then suddenly the handle gets into the food. And then you pick up the handle, and you're just like, I'm always just like, oh my God, I don't even want to be here. I don't even like face like that. No, I have a little sanitizer on. No, just kidding. And then, so that's why long tongs are best, so the handle does not fall into the food like that. That is a shaping dish, my friends. So let's get that shaping dish out of the way. And now we're going to talk about bamboo skewers. Bamboo skewers made out of bamboo. It is a type of wood. Why would I want to soak these overnight in water before I use them over an open flame? Because they'll start on fire. You know, not a whole lot of people know this. It does seem like it's common sense, but sometimes we're just not thinking. And suddenly you, I don't know, have you had little kebabs, or you skewer up some chicken or beef or something like that, put it on the grill, and then it lights on fire and it burns. It's not really an attractive presentation. So definitely we have a bamboo skewers. And now I think we're gonna attempt to make some indoor s'mores, gentlemen. So we each have our own little, thank you for setting it up, by the way. Oh, does this belong to, you got the half and half? You got the dark, is that cool, or you want the milk? Good, because I don't want the milk chocolate. So we have milk chocolate, we have dark chocolate. Milk chocolate are for kids, and dark chocolate are for the more mature types. Just kidding, whatever you want. Milk chocolate's not really real chocolate, I don't think, because it has some dairy product in there to thin it out, whatever. Anyway, you get three pieces, three rectangles per s'more. You guys get two s'mores. So what I like to do, because I want the chocolate on the top and the bottom, I'm gonna put two pieces, two rectangles on the bottom, and then save the other one for the top. Marshmallow, and you crowd around as if we are at a campfire. Kumbaya, kumbaya. And of course, why wait till you go camping when you can have indoor s'mores? When I used to live in Washington, D.C., there was a restaurant. And they serve, when it lights on fire like this, you just blow it out. They used to serve indoor s'mores, and they had a cool little setup because it looked like little logs of wood. And then you could just gather around. They would charge $15 for this. Get out, exactly, because it's so cheap to make. That's what I'm talking about, you know, for those fools who want to pay $15 to do the same thing. Try this at home. It's a lot of fun. People always have a lot of fun doing this. You know, marshmallow is just made out of sugar, so it can easily burn, just like those of you who weren't successful with the bloody kettle corn.
Group two.
So that's why. But sugar burns quickly, that's just how it is, okay? But once it's really burnt up, so you'll see, what we want to get this molten inside. My advanced class, CA2, is making chocolate molten cakes today. Watch out, this recipe also has a warning on there that you can burn your tongue. Are we hogging up the flame or something? You're not getting anything.
No, I don't like mine.
Oh, yeah, you don't. Oh, carcinogens, that's right. You know, it can cause cancer, so watch out.
And mine's done, so I'm just going to grab the second piece.
That's right.
And I'm going to get it. I'm going to push down and pull the stick out.
I'm going to put my chocolate on top of the marshmallow, so I get chocolate on the top and the bottom. There is a top and the bottom of the graham cracker. And push down and... that. You use the same stick for the next one. And indoor s'mores, everybody. Happy Halloween. All right.